nice and slowly. As you get warmed up, you can start increasing the momentum, the speed, the movements, the range of motion. But like we always say, just do what you can. Anything is better than nothing. All right, so the first move is called a speed skater. In 4, 3, 2, 1. So it looks like this. So you're just swinging both hands across your front with a side tap. So during the next 30 minutes, you get tired, you take a break. Something hurts, don't do it. It gets too heavy, try doing it without a weight. So listen to your body, do what you can. Like I said, anything's better than nothing. All right, the next one, we're gonna clasp our hands in front with the back toe. In 4, 3, 2, 1. So hands clasped, and you're just bringing them overhead with that back toe tap. Now, this one's a little harder. It's gonna really get that heart rate up. So when we do overhead things, you just lift those hands over your head as far as you can, pain-free. The more you do that, the farther up you're gonna get those hands. Okay, so the third step is just a seated jumping jack. 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So we just do a side tap with our arms coming out to the side. I'm getting warmed up. I hope you are too. I'm so happy to hear that people are doing these exercises in their apartments. It doesn't get much more convenient than that. Keep breathing. We're gonna go back to march in 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to that march. Good. Really try to pick those knees up now. We're a little more warmed up. Make sure you're inhaling, exhaling. Doing a great job. All right, start slowing down that march. Good. All right, everybody. Let's get started on some strength training exercises. So the first one we're gonna do, I don't believe we've done this one before. We're gonna pick up two weights or no weights, your choice. All right, so your right hand is going to hang down on the side. Your left hand is gonna start out with a goalpost arm. As we bend down towards the right, we're gonna push that left hand up towards the sky for an overhead press, bring it back to the shoulder. So overhead press, bring it back. So that right arm is not doing anything but hanging on to that weight. Good, so you are using all of your oblique and core muscles and you're working on that overhead press. Exhale when you press overhead, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Good. Good. Exhale, let's do 4 more of these. 4, 3, 2, 1. Awesome. All right, we're gonna switch sides. Left hand hangs down by the side, by your side. Right arm comes up to a goal post. Make your feet a little bit wider and make sure they're flat on the ground for that stability. We push overhead as we lean to the left. Come back to where we started. Overhead, lean to the left. Good, so exhale on the exertion. Exhale as you overhead press. Exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Good job. Keep it up. Exhale. Let's do four more. Four, three, two, one. Awesome. All right, next one. This is called drumming. All right, so this is what you're gonna do. We're sitting tall in our seat. We're gonna hold our weights like we're holding drumsticks, okay? It's gonna get heavy. So if you wanna start out with weights and then put them down, you can do that. Or you wanna just do it without weights, you can do that too. If you want the challenge, grab those weights. All right, so pull that belly in. What we're gonna do is extend our arms out to the right. We're gonna start to drum, but we're gonna drum all the way around to the left. Drum all the way around to the right. Good. You are gonna feel this in your arms and in your core. Just keep breathing. Do not hold your breath. Woo, couple more. Nice job, everybody. You're doing great. Let's go to the left and back to the right. That'll be the last one. And rest. That was really good. Okay. All right. The next one. We're going to turn our palms facing out. All right. I'm bringing my feet a little farther ahead or in front. I'm going to hinge back a little bit, engage my core, which means pull that belly button in. All right. Palms are out. I'm hinged back. I'm going to pull my upper body forward and reach my arms overhead. My palms are still facing you. Your palms should still be facing me. Come back, hinge, pull straight up with that overhead. Come back, hinge, you're hinging back, but keep squeezing that core to protect that back. Good, if this gets too heavy, try doing it without a weight. You want that challenge? Then you grab those weights and keep it up. Good. Everybody goes to their own level. You do what you feel like doing today. This is your exercise class. Personalize it for yourself. Let's do three more. Three. Two. Last one. And bring it down. Good job. All right. We have not done any leg exercise in the chair because we're gonna get into that standing. But also, if you don't wanna stand, you can sit and do the same things, modified versions. All right. I'm gonna put the weights in my chair so that when I'm standing, I can grab them easily. We're gonna go right into those eight chair squats. If you choose to do chair lifts, you can. You want to stay in your chair, just push into those heels and squeeze. If you can get yourself up off an inch or two, good. If you just want to push into those heels and squeeze those legs, that's what you do. Otherwise, we're going to stand up and we're going to go into those eight chair squats. All right, so I'm making sure that seat is right behind me. Bring your hands out forward or crisscross and hug yourself. Ready? Keep your weight in your heels. Push those hips back. Drop down. And push the hips forward. Come back up. That's one. Now you want the challenge? You can tap that seat. That's two. Three. Nice job, everybody. four, even if you're just squeezing those leg muscles, that's good. Five, better than not doing anything at all. Six, seven, eight, oops, that's it. I was gonna go to 10. Okay, see what happens when I'm not paying attention? I just start counting and going on and on. All right, let's go into cardio. Let me find the appropriate song. I want something that's not too fast. And of course, I can't get my computer to, there we go. All right, I'm gonna go for Dolly Parton, if I can find her. Hang on, everybody. Well, where is she? I can't find her, so we'll do this one. I didn't want anything too fast. Okay, so we're gonna start with that march. I'm gonna march right up here and move this a little bit. Keep marching. Thank you for being so patient with Maggie and I. We are not videographers. We don't edit anything. What you see, what we do, that's what you get. You guys are good sports. All right. Speed skater is first. In 4, 3, 2, 1. So we're gonna speed skate. So my arms are just swinging from side to side. If you're in your chair, same thing that we did the first time we did this cardio. If you're standing, you're just tapping out side to side. Nice job, everybody. All right, next one is those hands clasped in front with the back tap. In 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So, I'm bringing those arms overhead, tapping behind me. So it's a little harder. If you're not stable, do it in your chair, or use one hand to put the other one on the back of your seat. Nice job. Keep it up. Next move are those jumping jacks. We don't do real jumping jacks. We do modified jumping jacks. In 4, 3, 2, 1. So, just side tap again. Arms out to a T and drop them down. So if you're in the chair, same thing. Keep breathing. We're gonna go back to march. In 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep going. We're going to do that march. And then we're going to start to slow it down. Good. All right. Second cardio is done. Okay. So we are going to stand beside the chair with one weight. Okay, if you're seated, you can do the same thing, except you're going to be sitting, of course. If you're standing, I want you to take the outside leg. So if you're on this side of your chair, you're gonna take your left leg front, right leg back. So outside leg is front. Now, hang onto that chair with your right hand. Left hand's holding onto the weight, palm facing the leg. As we go down, we're gonna do a hammer curl. Straight back up. So you're just bending both knees and going straight down, straight back up. So straight down with that hammer curl, straight back up. Make sure you've got your hand on the back of that chair. You don't want to do the lunge, you don't have to. You can just stick with the hammer curl. Good. Let's do four more. Four. Three. Two. Last one. Nice job. All right, go to the other side of your chair if you're standing. So you're on the other side, outside leg. So in this case, my left leg's gonna come forward. I mean, my right leg's gonna come forward, left leg going back. Weight is in my right hand, palm facing my leg. So same thing, my back toe is on the ground and my heel is up right now. I'm gonna just bend both legs, hammer curl, come back up. Down, come back up. You do not have to go down very far. You go as far as you are comfortable. My back heel is up the entire time. I'm just on the back ball of my foot. Or the ball of my back foot. That makes more sense. Let's do four more. Four. Three. Two. One. Good. All right. So I'm going to grab two weights. You can grab two weights if you want, or one weight or no weight. So we're going to do that upright row with a sumo squat. So just spreading our feet out a little bit, palms facing my legs, weights are together, almost like they're glued. If you're using one weight, you're gonna grab it like this, okay? So you can pull it right up under your chin. Otherwise, two weights. We're gonna go down, straight down. So keep those knees open, pull the weight under your chin. Drop it down. And again, drop it down. And again. Good, make sure those knees aren't falling in. Keep them pressed open. Keep your weight in your heels. Squeeze those glutes. Squeeze those shoulder blades as you pull those weights up. Good, let's do four more of these. Four. Three. Two. Last one, and rest. Awesome. All right, we're gonna put the weights down. I'm just gonna set mine on the ground. So the next exercise is all lower body. So I'm gonna have my right hand on the chair. My left hand is free, or it's gonna be on your hips, wherever you want it. You can put it out to a T. I'm probably just gonna have mine on my hips. My feet are gonna be hips distance apart. We're gonna go down into a little squat. We're gonna stand up and do a lateral leg lift. So it looks like this. Hips go back, squatting down, push into those heels, push those hips forward, lift that leg out. Drop it down. Let's do that again. Hips back, hips forward, left leg comes out. Make sure that toe is facing forward. So squat, come up, leg lift. Squat, come up, leg lift. Good. Now you can go your speed. If I'm going too slow for you or too fast for you, you go the speed where you're comfortable. Keep it up. Nice job, everybody. So let's do four more on this side. That's four. Three. Two. Last one. Nice. All right, I'm gonna switch to the other side of my chair. Okay, left hand on the seat. My right hand's gonna be on my hip. Yours can be wherever you want it to be. Feet, hips width distance apart. We do a squat, we come up, lift that leg out. So hips back, push them forward, leg out. Make sure when you lift that leg out, it's straight and the toe is forward. Good. Nice and controlled. Nice job. Let's do four more. That's four. Three. You've got it. Two. Last one. Lift it up. Awesome. Good job. Shake those legs out and have a seat. Last but not least, just a strict core exercise and then stretching. All right, so we're gonna do leg flutters today. So we're gonna sit on the front half of our chair, hinge back so that your back is resting on the back of the seat. Hands can be on either side of the seat of your chair. Bring those feet out front, okay? So maybe we'll go between flutter and scissor kicks. So let's do flutters first. So flutter kicks, we just lift those legs up, point our toes and flutter them. So squeeze your abdominal muscles. Make this hard. Pull that belly in. Good job. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Rest. And then we're gonna go up and do scissor kicks. So scissors where we crisscross. All right, here we go. Lift those legs up, point those toes, and crisscross. Good. Alternate what foot goes on top if you can. Continue to breathe. Awesome. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Nice job, everybody. Ooh, all right, let's stretch. Okay. Go ahead and place your right foot straight out in front of you, toes towards the sky, nice tall spine, and hinge forward. While you're doing that, I'm gonna drop this down. All right. So back is flat. Head is in line with your spine. It's all one straight line, hinging forward. Keep breathing as you're letting those back leg muscles stretch. All right, let's come up from that side. Pull that leg in, make sure that foot's flat on the ground for some safety and stability. Left leg is out, toe is up, hinge forward. Continue to breathe, good stretch. Let's pull up from that side. Pull that foot back in. Let's get into those hips. So cross that leg over. Nice tall spine. Hinge forward. So make sure you're pulling that lower belly forward. Make sure you can feel this in your hip. Take nice breaths here. Keep letting that torso sink. All right, let's push up from that side. Uncross that leg. Get into the other side of those hips. Nice tall spine. Hinge forward. So make sure you're feeling it in your hip. If not, pull that back flat. Pull your lower belly forward. Deep breathing. All right, let's come up from that one. Uncross that leg. Let's turn our knees to the side. Doesn't matter which side, but to make sure you're securely on your seat. All right, bring those hands behind you. Grab whatever you can grab or interlace your fingers. Pull them down. Get those shoulders nice and low. Then pull them away from your back. Keep breathing. Opening up that chest. Just trying to lift those hands away from your back. One more inhale. See if you can lift it 1 inch. And exhale, drop those arms. Good. Come back around to the front. Let's bring one arm across. Nice stretch in that shoulder. Hope everybody enjoyed that. Hope you feel good. All right, let's bring that same arm up and over the back. Grabbing or pushing that tricep or grabbing the elbow. And give yourself a little scratch with your fingers that are back there. They can reach. And let that arm drop. Good. Be nice and gentle. Bring that other arm across. Giving that shoulder a nice stretch. All right, let's bring that arm up and over our shoulder. Pushing on that tricep or grabbing that elbow. This is good for the back scratch test that we do for our fitness assessments. Woo, and bring that down. We won't hold that one that long. Roll those shoulders out. Give them a nice little break. Good, roll that neck a little bit. All right, let's do 3 deep breaths. Inhale, fill up those lungs. Exhale, blow it out. Inhale, fill them up. Exhale, blow it out. Good. Fill them up. Blow it all out. Congratulations. You completed another Ageless Strength class. Good for you. Hope you enjoyed that. I'm proud of all of you for doing these classes. Take care. See you next time.